Kenya today, 53 different languages. Let's take advantage of those and see how we can, as a country, grow in a more robust way, celebrating our culture. As you know, as you've seen in the past, people have taken advantage of language or their tribe to hide and then tell their communities, you know, certain things that include hate speech. We're trying to say, no, let's celebrate this. Let's all understand what each community is saying. Let's be all inclusive. And when people speak hate, you know, that can become obvious and evident. And under the Ministry of ICT, we are using technology to make sure that we are disseminating both language and entertainment and all the education that comes with the language policy across not only the country, but even to the diaspora, so that we can benefit as a country. So we don't want to lose who we are. We want to actually grow. And as you can see, we have even the Ministry of Arts and Culture involved here, Sports, Arts and Culture, and we want to, you know, ensure that this is an interministerial event or project that we are undertaking. The plan is that within the next 60 days to 90 days, we're actually going to have the policy in place. But we want to make sure we take all input from the stakeholders. You've heard in the conversation, some are even saying, you know, what are the advantages? You may have recently seen the new application. It's on a mobile app on Android called Wanjala, Bond Wanjala, which people are taking advantage of the circumstances going on and celebrating our culture. Now that's like hangman, and it's being taken. So with all that in mind, I think we're going to see a lot of benefit. So we are taking time. Let's use technology. Let's come together as Kenyans. Policy where we want to ensure we have all people included. We are talking of those people with disabilities, youth, and even marginalized communities. We want to make sure we've got all the languages captured so that then we can celebrate.
When this policy is implemented in the right way and with us on board and keeping on check on what is being delivered to different stakeholders, I believe it will have a big impact, and it will create awareness and also ensure that persons with abilities are equal participants in terms of information being delivered in different languages. One of the major issues, first of all, is the recognition. When the different languages applied by persons with abilities are recognized, it is a step ahead. And from that is when you can now ask for more in terms of standards of the language being developed, like the sign language standards being developed, Braille standard regulations, which can impact in terms of how different professional stakeholders are implementing their activities. For example, when interpretation is being done in our televisions, or when we have teaching within the school, or even within the normal having the newspapers around, which are not yet having another alternative language, this one will help stakeholders to create more platforms for different individuals.
Forget your color, forget your tribe. We want one tribe known as Kenya. We want a united Kenya. We want a peaceful Kenya. A land of freedom for everyone. Oh, let peace prevail in Kenya.
Of different alternative languages like sign language and Braille. And
Nasoma sana, but you can't communicate. So I think this is a very big challenge, and I want to comment the language policy, but I think it's a very big.
Who are not what we call brain literate, they might not be knowing how to contract. We find that one of the challenges he's facing Braille is that producing Braille is very expensive.
But
about and see how you can come up with adaptive technology and also help maybe innovators within the country. May it be some addresses which are being given, so we really need to look into. And language policy has really come up with these.